Hey y'all. Well, it is. I don't even know. I think Coco. No, it's like Coco wants to say hey. Coco, come here.
Coco says hey. Say hey. Hello, my little Coco. She's so tiny. She's literally 4 pounds. Anyway, it's like 5 o'clock here, close to it anyway. And I'm super sorry, but I've been really crazy. I'm gonna say it's been a day of maybe say challenge, but also success and learning. And I don't know, I'm just gonna spin everything positive. I don't care how hard it gets. That's just bringing me closer to where I need to be and closer to the end and the blessings, the better times. So, one thing I heard today that I thought was amazing that I love from Coco Chanel, which I love Chanel. She said, a woman or a girl, actually, a girl should be two things. Oh, Chloe just came here. Hey, Chloe, come here. Let's say hey. Come here. Come say hey. I'm in my bedroom.
There's Chloe. Say hey. You've been sleeping? You've been sleeping today. Oh, I love you.
Love dogs and cats, but I just have dogs. Anyway. Back to Coco Chanel, sorry. A girl should be two things, who and what she wants to be. Yeah, amazing. Same thing for a guy. You just should be who and what you want to be and not let the world and everybody else twist and turn you into this pretzel that you never were meant to be. And it's never too late. It's always the right time. Everything happens at the right time. You just have to trust that it's bringing you to where you need to be. So I also have this book that I've been reading. Let's see if you can, if I can get it in there. Oh, there you go. Positive energy. It's just exactly what I believe. What you know that I say, you bring to you, what you put out there, and it's very difficult in certain situations to not put out their negative and to not let that negative overwhelm you. But don't do it because as soon as you do, that's what you're bringing to you. And yeah, anyway, I just thought that was a good book. And I was thinking about something my girlfriend told me today that I can't say, but maybe I can say it later. It's pretty funny though. It's about karma. Then I looked at this book that I love called Instant Happy, and I said, let me just, I literally, oh, something just fell out of there. I literally do like this. I pick up the book and then I go, and like whatever, you know what. Open, what is it open to? And so this is what it opened to, which looks like a speeding car. You can see all those like lines. And I was thinking, wow, I feel like that. Because I didn't really get any sleep last night for one thing. Clayton went to a concert from the band Flume, but there was a lot of bands that played ahead of it. I don't know what they are, but it was like really, really late when he got in. And so of course I'm like that mom that I cannot go to sleep until my kids are here. Like I'm not gonna go to sleep and think and wake up in the morning and they're not here. I just can't do it. I can't go to sleep. So anyway, literally, do y'all ever notice when you go when you don't get much sleep, your brain starts like instead of like it starts going, it's like skipping. Like I feel like that's what my brain's doing. But anyway, so and already I'm all over the place, ADD big time. So if you add in no sleep, it really creates major. But anyway, back to what it says, the best things happen at the exit ramp. From your comfort zone. So I think there was two things in that for me. Sometimes, you know, you feel like your life, oh, I wish you could feel that breeze. Amazing. I'm gonna show you my balcony. It's been not sunny all day. Anyway, back to this. The best things happen at the exit ramp. Sometimes you don't wanna be on the exit ramp. Like, you know, have you ever been driving and you get off at the wrong thing and you're exiting and you don't know where the crap you are and you start I mean, I start panicking. I don't want to be on the exit ramp. I don't want to, you know, kind of like that. Well, I feel like that sometimes in my life, like, I don't want to be on this ramp. I don't want to be on this thing, you know, get me off. The best things happen at the exit ramp. And the next thing is from your comfort zone. Okay? So whenever you're not comfortable, hello. That's the best things happen. So I don't know. Those were good things for me today. They helped me. And I think kind of try to keep in mind that, you know, your comfort zone, I like my comfort zone. Thank you very much. I'll be happy to be back in a comfort zone. But when you're out of your comfort zone, you're absolutely forced to stretch and forced to grow. Either go with it and learn all these new things. Like another analogy I had was you're just taken, somebody takes you, throws you out in the middle of the ocean, and you don't know how to swim. You kind of know how to tread water a little bit, but you really don't know how to swim. And they say, good luck, hope you make it, figure it out. And you're just treading forever, and then you see them throwing some like shark bait in the water, like a lot of bloody stuff, so the sharks will come. And you're still swimming, you're still going. Somehow, you're actually getting closer to the, you know, land. That's what you do, you know. Push through all that. Try to smile and laugh at least one time a day. I try to do it several times a day. And sometimes when it's like a lot of, you know, my laughs are so huge and I think it's just such a huge release. But anyway, I don't know. Like I said, I'm super tired. I've been around the block in my brain. I don't know what I've really said right here. But what I am saying and what I am doing in my life is choosing happiness because it's a choice. And you can choose to be bitter and negative and mean and hateful. And then you can just bring all that to you. Or you can choose to say in the midst of getting pounded or in the midst of just getting, you know, fed grapes or, you know, whatever, a palm tree fanning you, wherever your situation, choose to be good, kind, and loving. And that's what you bring to you. That's the energy you bring. It's true. And energy is contagious and it's positive. So I'm sending you as much of my positive energy and love and joy for life that I can. And I know you're sending it back. And I appreciate it. And I have not had time to answer a lot of things on the blog, just like I'm, you know, kind of having a hard time. Some days I get up 4 or 5 videos, other days I get up 1. But know you're in my heart, and I am definitely feeling you, and I hope you're feeling me. Much love, you guys.